So hi everyone and welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more important questions from the PIB news which are important for all the government exams. Alright, so let's begin with the session without any delay. But before we begin, we have launched a crash course for the upcoming RBI Grade B exam. So if you want to ace the exam this year, you can enroll in this course and you can download the Anujinder app from the Google Play Store where you can get all the stuffs related to your examination. And if you want to ask anything related to examinations, you can follow me here. And let's talk about the very first question. Which ministry has launched Sajal project to provide safe drinking water to school students of 5 districts of Haryana? Kaun se ministry ne Sajal project launch kiya hai to provide drinking water to school students from 5 districts of Haryana? So remember guys, this is Ministry of Finance, okay? Not Ministry of Jal Shakti, not Ministry of Rural Development, not Ministry of Panchayati Raj. This is Ministry of Finance. So Ministry of Finance, through the Income Tax Department, through various Income Tax Departments under its jurisdiction, has launched this project which is known as Sajal project. Alright. Now, this will provide safe drinking water to school students, as it was already mentioned in the question. This will enable the students to have a nurturing environment to have their studies and activities. Okay, of course, peene ka paani is the very basic need. Agar peene ka paani hi nahi hoga, to kis baat ki studies hai, kis baat ki padhai hai, aur kis baat ki likhai hai. Alright. Now, remember, 20 government schools have been identified under the project in 5 districts of Haryana, which are Panipat, Faridabad, Palwar, Gurugram, and Sonipat. Do remember the name of these 5 districts as well. Okay, this can be asked in your exam. Out of these districts, which is the not, which one is the not where this Sajal project has been launched by Ministry of Finance? Aisa question bhi pucha ja sakta hai. Alright. Now remember, the need of this project is that because these schools are located in the rural areas with industrial belts. Ye schools jo identify kiye gaye hai, these are located in the rural areas jahan pe industrial belts hai. And kyunki bhai yahan pe industrial belts hai, so the groundwater in these areas are contaminated, and that's why there is a need for this project. Alright. So therefore, the correct answer will be what? Ministry of Finance, headed by Nirmala Sitharaman. Option D will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 2. How many ropeway projects will be developed in Himachal Pradesh under the Parvatmala Pariyojana? So as we all know, Parvatmala Pariyojana was announced in this year's Union Budget, under which various ropeways will be developed across the countries. Earlier, this similar MOU was signed with the government of Uttarakhand, under which 7 ropeways will be developed. 7 ropeways will be developed in Uttarakhand. And in this MOU with Himachal Pradesh also, 7 ropeways will be established in the state of Himachal Pradesh. So the correct answer to this will be 7 ropeways. And remember, the total length of these ropeways will be 57.1 kilometer with a total cost of 3232 crores. Now, I know you must be wondering this fact ki bhai, budget mein toh they have announced that they are going to construct, that they are going to establish 8 ropeways with 60 kilometer of length. Then how is it possible that 7 ropeways are already under construction in Uttarakhand and 7 in Himachal Pradesh, and the total becomes 14? So how is it possible? So I also don't know. ठीक है कि ये कैसे हो रहा है, but yes, जो PIB में mention है वो यही है, government की तरफ से यही है. हो सकता है कि उन्होंने वो जो target number है उसको increase कर दिया हो, जिसकी कोई official information जारी नहीं की गई है. But yes, in Uttarakhand also the 7 ropeways will be developed and are under construction under this Pariyojana or project Parvatmala, and in Himachal Pradesh also 7 projects have been identified to be constructed under Parvatmala Pariyojana worth 3232 crores and a total length of 57.1 kilometers. Alright. So therefore, the correct answer will be what? Option D, 7. 7 ropeways projects will be developed in Himachal Pradesh. Moving ahead to question number 3. An MOU has been signed between CSIR and iCreate for rapid economic development. Who is the chairperson of CSIR? Prime Minister of India is the ex-officio chairperson of CSIR. And who is the Director General? Dr. Shekhar Mande. Dr. Shekhar Mande. Okay, CSIR and iCreate ke beech mein ek MOU hua hai for rapid economic development and help create world-class startups. So basically, for creation of world-class startups, this MOU has been signed between CSIR and iCreate. But the question is not this. Question is, iCreate is a flagship technology incubator of which state? So this is a very good question, and इसमें से बहुत अच्छा question बन सकता है exam में इस news में से. iCreate एक flagship technology incubator है कौन से state का? So remember, the state is Gujarat. So this MOU signed between CSIR and iCreate, which is Gujarat's flagship technology incubator. And why this MOU has been signed? The objective is already given in the question. For development of world-class startups. And of course, talking about iCreate, so it is an autonomous center of excellence located in Ahmedabad in Gujarat. It is located in Ahmedabad in Gujarat. Do remember this also. So it is a center of excellence under Gujarat's government for basically developing the startups. And it is the largest institution across the country which has transformed various startups into successful businesses. Okay? So therefore the correct answer will be what? Option D, Gujarat. Gujarat will be the correct answer. Chief Minister of Gujarat is Bhupendra Patel. Question number 4. With which of the following organizations, APIDA, which is Agricultural and Processed Foods Export Development Authority, has organized International Food and Hospitality Fair, AHAR. Do remember the name of this fair. They can ask you the name as well. That which fair was organized by APIDA in collaboration with ITPO for promotion of exports of GI certified agricultural products. Okay, so in that case the answer would be Prahar, but here in this question they are asking with which organization APIDA has organized AHAR. So the correct answer is what to this question is India Trade Promotion Organization, option A. All right, and there is no need to go into other details of this news. That is not required for the exam. Next question is again one marker. Which e-commerce company has signed an MOU with Department of Empowerment of Persons with Disabilities, which works under the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, headed by Dr. Virendra Kumar, and Sector Skill Council for Persons with Disabilities for skill training and employment opportunities for persons with disabilities? So this is a tripartite MOU which has been signed between among three organizations. One is this Department of Empowerment of Person with Disabilities. Second is Sector Skill Council for Person with Disabilities. And the third, which is an e-commerce company, is Flipkart. Option C. Flipkart will be the correct answer, guys, to this question. Moving ahead to question number 6. Which of the following campaign will be organized by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare? And these days, guys, most of the news are such which are of only one markers. Okay? तो आपको चिंता करने की बात नहीं है, अच्छी बात है बल्कि ये कि कम न्यूज होंगी तो आपको कम पढ़ना पड़ेगा, ठीक है? बट यस, ये सारे के सारे जो न्यूज है जो हम पढ़ रहे हैं वन मार्केट में, ऑल दीज आर इम्पोर्टेंट. ऑलराइट, सो विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कैंपेन विल बी ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड फार्मर्स वेलफेयर, हेडेड बाय एनएस तोमर, नरेंद्र सिंह तोमर, टू मेक द फार्मर्स अवेयर अबाउट द की स्कीम एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ प्रधानमंत्री फसल बीमा योजना. सो एज यू ऑल नो अबाउट दिस स्कीम, प्रधानमंत्री फसल बीमा योजना, आई हैव डिस्कस्ड इट so many times, and these days the revision sessions of government schemes are also being conducted by me. So usme bhi Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana ko humne discuss kiya tha. It is basically a crop insurance scheme which gives insurance to the crops of the farmers, hai na? And this campaign is Fasal Bima Paathshala, option A. Fasal Bima Paathshala is the correct answer. This is the campaign that will be organized by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. And the last question for today, which of the following organizations has organized National Workshop on Innovative Agriculture for Promoting Natural Farming? So remember, this National Workshop on Innovative Agriculture was focused on promotion of natural farming. ठीक है, तो basically क्या आप ये जो इस तरीके के सेमिनार हो गए, इवेंट्स हो गए, या वर्कशॉप हो गए, या कैंपेन्स हो गए, इसमें से ना यही चीजें पूछी जाएंगी कि किसने किया, नाम क्या था और ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या था, दैट्स इट. इससे ज्यादा नहीं पूछा जाएगा. Which organization has organized, what was the name of the campaign, and what was the objective. That's it. These three or four things are more than enough for such news. All right. And this national workshop has been organized by Niti Aayog. Option B, Niti Aayog. And there is a question to you all. Can you tell me who is the newly appointed vice chairperson of Niti Aayog? Write down in the comments. Very easy question. Aur sabko pata hoga, I believe. So pata hai to comment zarur karna. Option B, Niti Aayog is the correct answer to this question. And that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. एंड नेक्स्ट सेशन में मिलेंगे फ्राइडे को, तब तक पढ़ते रहो और पढ़ते रहो और पढ़ते रहो. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.